Okay, this video is entitled Loop Within a Loop, but it is not the video you think it is. It is not the next one, which is about nested loops, which is also about a loop within a loop. This is about a different kind of loop within a loop, which is something very specific to processing and animation programs, which I just feel is important to mention because it is a source of confusion when you're first beginning to program animations and repeat things in your code. Hit the microphone, so you might have heard a loud noise, or we're gonna use a different audio source. My finger as I went by there, so who knows? Anyway, I could just start over, but I can't. I just have to keep going. Okay, so here's the thing. What do I mean by loop within a loop in this video, which is not about nested loops? I mean this. Remember a while back in a video about flow, we talked about setup as the beginning of your program, draw about the thing that loops forever? Well, this is a loop. This loops over and over again. And we just said, okay, we could write loops inside of draw, like while x is less than width, float x equals 0 and x equals x plus 20 and draw some sort of line, blah, blah, blah. That's essentially what is happening over here in this program. If I run it, we can see we have this loop that says draw a line, repeat that a certain number of times across the screen until you get to the width spaced out by 20. So what I mean, this may be obvious to you, and if it's obvious to you, then awesome. You could just stop now. But what's going on? This is a loop, and this is a loop. The reason why this gets confusing is you might have an instinct to use a loop to animate something. For example, what if I want to show one line at a time? First draw the line at 0, then go up by 20, and then draw the line again, then go up by 20, and then draw the line and go up by 20. This is not the loop to do that. This is for doing something multiple times within one animation cycle. This outer loop, the main draw loop, that's the thing to say draw it first, then go up by 20, then draw it again. So what I'm asking you as an exercise, and you could pause right now and try to figure this out, is let's look at this output. What if we wanted to see one line appear at a time? Right now, when I run this program and run it again, we just see, boom, all the lines at once. I want to see one line at a time. Well, we still could use this loop within a loop, but we need to vary something about it. So I'm going to go no further. I'm going to go further, but I'm going to first say, you know, take a moment to meditate. You could pause the video. And you're back. So maybe you tried it. Maybe you succeeded. Maybe you failed. Let's take a look at how this is done. So if we want to animate something, your instinct might be, well, this animates it, and what if I just kind of like slow it down? Like I could say, like, there's even this function in processing called delay. I can't believe I even mentioned there's a function called delay. Never use delay. But you could say delay like by 1,000 milliseconds, which is like 1 second. I should see them one at a time. Oh man, come on. All it's doing is it's delaying each time through the loop, but we're not going to see the result until we get through the end of draw. So this is not for doing an animation. Draw is for doing an animation. But let's look at something interesting. It's not even getting anywhere. Because that's a lot of lines at 1,000 seconds per line. 1,000 milliseconds maybe is a while. Anyway, let's get rid of that. That's awful. Okay, what if, let me run this. I have lines all the way across the screen. What if I say x, the exit condition for the loop is when x is less than width divided by 2. Halfway across the screen. If I say x is less than, you know, 50, I get like two or three lines, whatever that is, over here. Behind me. Over there, there. Okay, so what's going on? If I just change this value, I get a different number of lines. What should that tell you? That should tell you that why don't I turn that into a variable? For example, what if I said mouse x? Oh, I have to move the mouse. Now I have the number of lines. That loop is each time through draw, the loop is happening, but it's happening sometimes a few times, sometimes many times. The point is, the outer loop is what's changing it because it's drawing that loop a certain number of times, a different number of times each time we go through draw. This is not animating. This is doing all at once and showing us the result when we get to the end. So where can I start? I could add a variable. I could call it end x. And I could say end x equals width, or equals 0. And I could put while x is less than end x. Now, here we go. What if I say, okay, I get, because end x is 0, what if I say end x is 100? Now we have this many lines. What if I say end x is 200? Now we have this many lines. This should give you a clue that I don't need to keep typing in a new value. I could just say, hey, end x equals end x plus 1. And now when I run this, we see, you know, what is the value of end x? It's going up and up every frame. So it's giving us the appearance of that loop doing it one at a time. But actually, we're doing the loop each time. We're just doing some of the loop, then more of the loop, then more of the loop, then more of the loop. We're actually doing the whole loop each time. But the whole loop is a smaller portion, then a larger portion, then a larger portion of the whole window. So this is an important concept, which is, I hit the microphone again. OK, but we have alternate audio sources, or hopefully it won't be so horribly loud. But this is an important concept to realize that this loop is always executed in its entirety, and the result is shown at the end of draw. So don't get confused. The main draw loop is for the purpose of animation. We want to vary each time for that main draw loop. The loop inside of draw is for repeating an element multiple times in one frame of animation. OK, hopefully that made sense. This was a little bit, you know, it sort of, it feels like I feel like I understand it. I feel like I don't know if I communicated that so well. But I could always remake this video, and you will send me comments by filling out the form below on your screen or dialing 1-800. Ask me to tell me my video should be better. This is the end. This was about 6 minutes, which I think is pretty good. Okay, goodbye.